Hi guys, welcome to the Tech Granth. Today we are going to solve the Leetcode problem of WordBreak 2. Do like and share the video, subscribe to the channel to get further update. So today's problem is given a non-empty string s and a dictionary wordDict containing a list of non-empty word. Add spaces in s to construct a sentence where each word is a valid dictionary word and return all such possible sentences. So some notes are there that same word in the dictionary may be reused, and you may assume the dictionary does not contain duplicate words. So if cats and dog is there, then in dictionary we have cat, cats and sand and dog. So we have two output, cats and dog and cats sand dog. Same goes for pineapple. So if you see here, they have used apple twice, which is from this node. Same word in the dictionary may be reused. So how can we tackle this problem? So if we take this example here, it seems like we need to go till here, then start from here, break the word, then go till here and break the word like this. And in the second scenario, it seems like we need to go till here, break the word, and then again break the word. So there are two possibilities for this. We need to choose one. So the first one is we should go till here, break this, then come back and break all these two. Basically, break the second half first. And once we have this result, then take this string and break this string into two parts like this and like this. Or the other way around is you start from the initial thing, this thing, you come till here, break this, then use this, and then break the word like this. So the better approach for breaking this will always be when you go till the end and then break the sentence. So I'll go through the code, and once we are done, you will be able to understand why it is easy to, or why it is better approach to break from the end. So let us try to code for this. So we have our string s and list of dictionary words. We can simply put something like s equal to null, or in case s is empty basically, or length is zero, so s dot length is equal to zero. In that case, we will simply return, we need to return null, but what we can do is we can create a result here. Will return this result, and in case it is not null, then we need to see if s, or the other way around, if that word is present in dictionary or not. Dot contains this string s. If it contains, then in our result we will add the word, we will add this. Okay, so we'll look for the result. If it is present, then we will add, and then we'll move forward with our processing. So suppose this whole word was present in the dictionary, we could have added it. Now if it is not present, then what we will do is we will iterate through the string that we have at hand, and we'll say I is less than dot length I plus plus, and we will have a temp string here, string temp, and this temp string will contain s dot substring of I, and let us start it with one because the first word, if it was present, we added it here only. So if this whole word is not there, then next we will do a substring of this and we will check whether this part of the word is present in the dictionary or not. So we'll say if word dictionary dot contains this temp, if the word is present in the dictionary, then in that case we will send that word and we will try to break it again. So if this word is present, basically this word, or later on it can turn out to be this word, if it is present in the dictionary, then we need to break the first half of the string. So we'll say some list of temp is equals to, you call the word break again and you call it with s dot sub string. Now since the last part is already present, we need to break the first half. So we'll say substring of 0 comma I, and we'll pass the word dictionary now. So we will recurse through our word function and we want to break the first half of this. So once we get back the result of this cat and dog, what we can do is we can simply append the result to our substring. So if this temp that we have got, if it is not empty, if this temp dot size is greater than 0, so we will do for int j equal to 0, j less than temp dot size, j plus plus, and in our result we will add, basically what we will add is we will add whatever we got from temp. So temp dot get j plus, we'll put a space, and whatever temp string that we had initially for this particular loop, basically this is the thing which was present, so we'll add it, and we'll whatever we got the result in temp, which is of recursion, like that initially the temp was this and we sent cats and dog as part of the recursion in word util. So from here we got an answer like cat space sand, or cat space and. So we'll create two word here and we will append it just in front of the dog which was there as part of our temp. So once we have that, we can simply say from the function we will return the result, whatever result we have. Now this looks okay, but to the kind of problem we are tackling, we might face some issue. So let us run this and we'll see. Oops, stupid typing mistakes. So this is accepted. We will try one more example which is given here, and let us run this as well. this also looks okay. Now let me submit this. And boom. So it failed, saying that time limit exceeded, and the input it was trying to execute is something like this. Let me copy it down. So the input that is given to us has this lots of A and a B in between, and then again a lot of A. Now a lot of them will be matching here. Now this pattern will match this pattern, this pattern, this pattern, all these dictionary words will match a number of cases here. So what will happen is when we are recursing, that time it will try to split all these A, like give you an example here. So when we started from here, we'll come till how many are there here? 3, 3, 6, some 10 are there. So till this particular point, we will come, and then our function will recurse. Basically it will recurse, then again some 10 will come and it will match this. So that is why it is taking a long time, and while reconstructing also it has to reconstruct all these, because this will be further split, like all these cases are there. So there are a lot of matches, so that recursion process is going for a toss. So there is a simple method, we just need to add, there is a concept called memoization. Basically you memorize the previous result that we have got, and that can be done using a map. So we will use a map which will be of string and list of string. So we'll call it memory map equal to new hash map, and even before adding all the result here, we can put a check if this memory map dot contains key. If the string that I'm getting currently, if this is present in my map, then I will not do all these processing. I'll simply return the result from my map. So I will return it from my map. I'll say dot get s. So whatever list that I formed initially as part of this map, I will return it. And what we need to do here is, just before returning the result, we will populate this map. So when we populate, we'll say this dot put, and I'll add our string here, whatever we are getting, and the result that we have calculated till now, maybe from here or from here. So we will add that result as part of this memory map. So the changes that we did was, we added the result here. So if you see this example where we were failing, so in this example, suppose once we have stored the value till here, till AAB, then next time the string which we have split after this, if this value comes again for joining, so we will simply return this value, whatever the value we can split it from here, that we can return from the map itself, rather than going back and forth the loop for breaking it and doing the recursion. So we just need to create a map, we need to return it from the map, and every time we have a result, we just put it in the map. So this should be able to help. Let us run this example itself. So if I run this, seems okay. This one is accepted, which was failing previously. So let us submit the answer. So it is accepted this time, and it says that we are faster than only 56.05%. The reason being, some of the guys who submitted their answer, they tried to be really smart and they worked their way around. Rather than splitting the string, basically they went through this word dictionary and they checked whether all these words can, all the words in the dictionary can form this string or not. If it can form, then they can basically create the word from the dictionary. But I personally do not feel that might be a good approach. Maybe the kind of cases that LeetCode has given here, it will be a brilliant approach. But in general case, your dictionary can be very large. It can have like, suppose your word that you have got here is of 5-6 character or like 10 characters and your dictionary has a million word, then that approach will not work. And I will suggest to follow the conventional approach where you split this string, because if you follow this approach, there can be a lot of problem that you can solve, which is based out of this. For example, another problem that can fall under this category is, you need to, suppose you are given a string like this and you have a dictionary and you need to find the minimum spaces that you can put so that everything matches here. Like for this example, if you see here, you have two cases. Here you have put like three spaces, here you have put two spaces, here also you have put two spaces. So the minimum number of space that you can put so that the string has everything from the dictionary and it forms a word. So that kind of problem, if you can tackle, all those problem can be solved using this method itself. So yeah, choice is yours. This solution works pretty fine now. So see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.